What is up, guys? Ian here from Co-Career Today, taking that mindset of lack to mindset of abundance. Today, I just want to talk about the idea of feng shui and how you should implement just like new energy into your home frequently. And basically, I say this because I rearranged my room today and it feels way more open. And maybe that sign is not supposed to be there, that picture. So just always like improving and always getting better at your decorating as well as just placement of things really will set the mood right up for what you're there to achieve. So for example, if I want to have a desk area where I'm going to do a lot of work on my computer, well, I probably would angle the light so it's like lower, so the angle of the light's not going directly on my face. I would probably have light that's dim. I also would have a pretty good space around me, like I have a bookshelf and a pretty large desk just so I can get through all the things that I need to get through without moving too far. And how that's situated, how you clean your desk will really depend on what kind of person you are, but it also will depict on how much work you're going to be able to achieve. And the cleaner your space is, it typically will result in more work done at a better, more efficient rate. And that's just like on a pure psychological side, like it would just make sense that you'd be more efficient with less clutter. So that statement right there is the idea of feng shui. And the less clutter that we have in our lives, the more ability for energy to come and flow smoothly. And the concept of feng shui really deals with on how you set up your room and how much junk you have lying around. So what I did today, I actually just moved my bed and I just switched some things around, but I have way more space than I need all of a sudden. So just having that, I can probably like put a few more things around and really like really get that energy flowing. Another thing with feng shui and like desks, you typically want natural sunlight, and that goes back to like the light. So I would recommend like having it close to a window, like I do, and your bed kind of the same deal. You want that because you want to have a natural sunlight potentially for when you go to sleep and wake up. You wake up due to the sun, and just to really like get your daily dose of vitamin D in. And that's very crucial. A lot of people kind of lack on their sunlight intake, and I feel like it's very crucial if you're going to implement feng shui into your life. Now, feng shui also deals with the placement, like I said earlier. So realizing what works best for you just solely depends on what you have and like what you're going with. And I'd probably look up a few things on how feng shui works. Like for example, a bedroom should not be a place for work. It should be a place for very intimate things, sleep, and just recovery in general. So having your desk in your room isn't always ideal, but in certain circumstances, it's all you have. So in my case, I had to have my desk in my room. So just in that, my feng shui is gonna be a little different, but I'm gonna have to be able to just adjust myself to live with that. But what are other great feng shui tips? You know, fountains, mantra, like recordings. Something like ambient, something ambient in the background really helps ease in that mood. When you walk into a room, you want to feel welcome. You want to feel comfortable. And that's what feng shui really entails. And you can really get to that when you use like fountains per se, and maybe like mantras like I do. I have Om Tri Mahalakshmi mantra for success at all times in my room. And it really sets the mood for what my whole kind of life chapter is all about. It's about growing and headed towards success. So those are my tips and tricks about feng shui. I definitely would recommend reading up a little bit about feng shui. If you don't really know what it is, then definitely watch a few more videos, probably somewhere else. And I think you'll really be interested in on how it really plays into the work that you can get done through the lack of clutter and the result of efficiency. So have a beautiful day, guys, and I'll catch you later. Thank you.